Hello, welcome to our today's webinar, or let's say it's a virtual exhibition, a virtual trade fair. Thank you all that you got the time again to join us in today's webinar. And as you can see on the picture, today we have an exhibition. Usually now in May in Germany, in Nuremberg, we would have our Stone Tech exhibition. But yeah, due to the circumstances you all know, through COVID-19, we cannot meet in person. We cannot sit together and drink a glass of wine or beer and discuss new topics, new projects. So we have to come in this way to you and present some of our new products. As in all our webinars, also before, some of our some parts we will do here on the screen, and some parts we move over to our application table and do some product demonstrations. And as always, feel free to ask your questions through the chat. My colleague Otello will pop them through to me directly. I will answer them, or he will answer them directly to you. Okay, let's begin. Yellowing of adhesives in outdoor use is always a topic, was always a topic, will be always a topic, especially when we talk about epoxy resins or polyester resins. We know they have a tendency to yellow, and this could be an issue when you have a white material, light colored material, you want to bond them, you want to fill them, you want to have a perfect result, and then after some years or after some time, your filling, your bonding changes the color, like you can see here in the picture below. Here, this was some fountain wall, and here was a big repair took place, and here was a mixture of epoxy resin and stone powder material mixed together, filled into this big hole, polished, grinded, and it looks perfect. But after a few years, you see the resin starts to yellow, and now the result speaks for itself. It's quite visible. So this is what we don't want. Another example is here, this repair works at a wall cladding. There used to be some lettering, some logos of a company. The company moved, they removed the logos, and then they had to fill these drill holes, and they used some epoxy there. And after the time, the epoxy turned yellowish a little bit, and then you can see here the results. Not all epoxies or polyester behave the same. Some are yellowing quite fast, some are yellowing slower, but in the end, all of them, they have a tendency to turn yellowish. But there's a third group of chemicals, of adhesive, which we have in our program. This is polyurethane adhesive, and here high quality polyurethanes. And here you can do quite some tricks with the formulation to adjust them to according to UV radiation and yellowing. So usually the field of polyurethanes is a huge field, is a big field. You have very cheap construction polyurethane foam. Yeah, but then you have also the high quality polyurethanes where we are talking about now today, and they you can modify especially for these high end applications. And as you can see here, we have done some tests. We have some so-called QUV chambers where we can simulate weathering, where we can simulate UV radiation, rain over time, over years. But in a much shorter period of time, we can simulate many years. For example, the number of 500 hours in a QUV chamber simulates about 2 to 3 years of original weathering outdoors. And you can see what does that to standard epoxy resins, which used to be quite clear and transparent in the beginning. They turn yellowish after that time. Also, polyester resins turn quite yellowish after this 500 hours, or let's say 2 to 3 years of weathering. And compared to that, when you use a high quality polyurethane and you have modified that, which we have done, In our Everclear range, in this example, it's our Everclear 510. And you can see we have tested it for 1,500 hours. So three times the hours which we have done with the epoxies and polyesters, and still the Everclear stays clear, no sign of any yellow or yellowing or color change. And this 1,500 hours, they stay for about, you can say, 7 to 8 years of actual weathering. So this is a quite interesting field, this high quality polyurethanes. And where have we used this this product and this technology in our new product, Everclear 300? It's not a brand new product. So if you have followed us in the last webinars of the last months, I have introduced this product already one time or two times. But as it is new since the last exhibition, since last October, November, September, this is still new. We would have launched this now in our Nuremberg exhibition, Everclear 300. So what is that product? This product is a weather resistant adhesive. Yeah, it's frost thaw stable. So you can use it also in winter areas quite good, but it is not yellowing, in opposite to all the epoxies which you usually use when you go for outdoor frost thaw stable applications. A second big advantage of this product, first of course, it is not yellowing, which is a huge advantage for a frost stable product. And the second is, it is very fast. After 2 to 3 hours, you have already a fully cured product. Yeah, and this is at 20 degree, of course. This is unique in the world, I would say. Usually when you have frost thaw stable products, we talk about epoxies, and epoxies, they need 12 hours, 16 hours, sometimes 24 hours to cure completely. But this Everclear 300 cures in 2 to 3 hours fully. Plus it is not yellowing. And another advantage is it comes in our standard 400 milliliter cartridge. So if you're used to our Acapox 5010, for example, our Acapox 2030 cartridges, this is the same cartridge, but now filled with the Everclear 300. So you can use the same guns, the same equipment, all the same, but now with the advantages of not yellowing and faster curing time. We have it in 13 colors already. So these 13 colors, they follow again also our color code, which we have throughout all our products like Color Bond, Composite, Platinum, Acapox 5010 colored. We have our color system, and the Everclear 300, of course, stays in this color system. And so when you know you need a white color 1140, you get it also with the Everclear. These 13 colors, they cover about, let's say, 80% of all the colors, for example, of ceramics manufacturers, but also most of the natural stone we are covering with these colors. And especially like the white ceramics, they go outside now more and more, or porcelains. And here you need UV stable bondings. And we work together with some big manufacturers for this program. For example, you know, Dekton, of course, or Caesarstone. So they are already using this product in their manufacturing plans. So it's also a very proven product already. Yeah, but I think enough talking. I will show you the product in a practical way on our table. So this is the cartridge. Yeah, it is our standard 400 milliliter cartridge. As I said, it comes in these 13 colors. I will show them shortly under the screen again. And yeah, I will show you now a short application, what to do, for example, for a miter bonding when we want to do like this stairs. Maybe I turn this here. You can see this is a stairway we did with some ceramics for outdoor. And when you want to do this nice miter bonding, you can do this with the Everclear and you will not have any yellow line there whatsoever. Yeah, short side introduction. And because I said you can use it with our normal standard guns, with our Acapox guns, 400 milliliter guns. Yes, this gun looks now a little bit different than you're used to guns. This is because this is also a little bit of a new product. Actually, it's not a new product, but this is just the successor of this gun. I think you know this 400 milliliter cartridge gun, which we used to have, where you know the cartridge is fitting in perfectly. Now this is the old model, and the new model, when you order now, you will get this one. So we modified a little bit. It's a little bit more handy. It's easier to use. It looks better, in my opinion. But as you can see, it also fits this 400 milliliter 2-to-1 cartridge. So this is our standard cartridge. It's a 2-to-1 system perfectly. Okay, let's do a short application, and then I will come to the another benefits of this product. Yes, thank you, Otello, for switching to the overhead camera. First, I say it in every webinar, but it's very important because when there is some let's say issues with a cartridge glue, then mostly because of the applicator has done or has not done the right use of the cartridge in the beginning. So it's very important when you use a cartridge the first time that you check if out of both chambers material is coming out to the same time, like now. Yeah, you can see now there's out of A and B some material is coming out. Now the cartridge is ready to use, and you can put on the mixing nozzle. Also here, the nozzle, you cannot do any mistake. It has two chambers. You have to put it on there. You put a clamp there, and now you can see how it starts to mix. Yeah, and also here, important, please throw away the first few centimeters so you make sure everything is mixed well. Yeah, that's enough. Everything is mixed well. And also when it comes, for example, to miter bonding, that you're sure that there's no bubble inside the glue. And when you throw away a few centimeters, you're sure that's fine. And then you can go on with the application. So now the cartridge is ready. You know that the chambers are leveled, the mixing is proper, and now you can do a gluing, and there will be always a perfect result. So now I go here into my miter bonding, go right into the bottom of it. You can see how soft and smooth this product can get applied. And now there are different techniques. You have clamps, you have clips. Some of them use tapes. For small pieces like this, I always use a tape. And now you press it together. And now that's important that you press it only one time together. Don't open and close and open and close it, because then you suck again air inside the bonding. It's not good. You get bubbles again. You have to work a second time maybe, or you have a bad adhesion. So please make sure adjust before the right way. Then you press in the glue, and then you fix it one time, and then you have a good result. So of course, here we will not wait till it's cured, because it's a fast product. Yes, only 2 to 3 hours. But it's not like a color bond, like 10 minutes, 20 minutes, and I can process working. So I will leave that here for later. Yes, Everclear 300, frost thaw stable, weather resistant, outdoor adhesive, but UV stable, and in 2 to 3 hours, fully cured. And I think this combination is unique in the market. And then of course you can create some nice stuff like this. Ceramic stairways, they look like one piece. You don't have to put these metal frames, which are usually used on ceramic stairways. You don't need that. Here you have a nice bonded edge and stairways, and it looks like one piece. But also, let's say, swimming pool surroundings, everywhere where we have to bond, we have to glue, and you want it frost door stable and not yellowing. The Everclear 300 is the perfect product for that. Otello, let's switch back to the to the overhead camera again. I just show you also the colors again. We have here cut in line in this Jura marble and put all the different colors we have inside. And you can see it's a quite big variety. So a lot of white, cream, some black and gray tones, also some brownish tones. And as you can see, you can see it shining. All of our glues can be polished. Yeah, so you can get the same gloss like the stone or the marble. So that's also an advantage compared to other joints. You will see it looks like one piece. So that's so far from our Everclear 300. Not very new, yeah, but still quite new. It's came out the last 6 months. Are there any questions to this product?
Yes, Johannes. So hello, everyone. First, well, there's one question here. The viewer is asking, we're using the 5010 colored. Can we replace this product with the Everclear 300?
That's a good question. You know, our Archipox 5010 colored comes in the same cartridge. Yeah, is the Archipox 5010 is a epoxy based product. It has a similar application field. Basically, as I said, if you have already the gun, or that gun probably, because this is brand new, but this will come in future. If you have this gun, you can still just switch over to the Everclear cartridge. You can use it the same way. The Archipox 5010, yeah, is a very good product. It's also slow yellowing, but in the end, after some years, it could yellow. So that's a good reason to use it, especially on white and light materials, the Everclear 300. One thing what I have to mention, as for example, epoxy products like the 5010, the Archipox 5010, they can handle during curing application a little bit humidity. So that means when you have the stone pieces, you have just freshly cut them and they are a little bit humid, still a little bit wet. Usually it's enough to blow them dry with a pressurized air or something, and then you can bond. This is okay for epoxy, for polyurethane glues, but this is for all polyurethane glues. If it is Everclear or other polyurethane glue, the stone must be absolutely dry. Yeah, if you want to be glue the pieces together, no remaining humidity in the stone. This is the only difference for polyurethane adhesives. They need absolutely dry substrate, which is no problem on a ceramic because a ceramic does not take any humidity. So when you cut it, it's a little bit wet. You blow it dry with a pressured air. That's it. But when you have a natural stone, absorbent natural stone, here you have to be sure that material is very dry, that you can bond it. Later on, when it's cured after 2 to 3 hours, humidity is not an issue. Yeah, only during application, you have to be a little bit careful here. So that's the difference between, for example, the Archipox 5010 and the Everclear 300.
No more questions.
No more questions. Thank you, Otello. So we move further to our next topic. So this was Everclear 300. Ah, I have one more application example of the Everclear 300, or let's say 225. This was the product which we have shortly before the Everclear 300, but it works in a similar way, but it can demonstrate quite good the capabilities of UV stable Akemi products. And this was the restoration of the Sheikh Zayed Mosque. And this is a square area of about 15,000 square meters large. And it was fully covered with small mosaics, with small marble mosaics, mostly white mosaics. And these mosaics over time, they were installed with some polymer modified concrete and grout. And this looks after the years quite, let's say, ugly. Yeah, it becomes dirty. Some of them broke out, fall out. So this place has to be restored, renewed, renovated. And what was done over months, overnight, millions of these joints were opened, were cut open, drilled opened, and then cleaned. And then they were filled with our Everclear in the color code 1130, so a white Everclear, and the whole joints, the millions of joints were filled, polished, and afterwards the whole area was polished again and became a perfect result. And when you know Abu Dhabi, they can talk about sun, so they have 12, 13, 14 hours sun every day. And here we have really a practical example where this product has proven its UV stability already. When traveling is more easy and possible in future, please visit the square. It's a very beautiful mosque, and it's a fantastic work which they have done there. Okay, that's so far from the Everclear. And now move on to a real new product. This is our Acupure 150 sandwich adhesive. And this is again a polyurethane product, but in this case it's a elastic two-component polyurethane product, and this is, as the name says, sandwich adhesive. This is made for big sandwich panels, sandwich bonding. So when you want to glue, let's say, thin natural stone layers or thin ceramics on big plates like aluminium honeycomb boards or wooden subconstructions, to make lightweight construction panels, for example, the yard industry, elevators, airplane industry, where you want to have natural stone or ceramic look, but you need a lightweight construction where you have the glue. This ceramic or natural stone on a substructure, which is wood, which is aluminium honeycomb or all other materials. Like here are some illustrated examples. I will shortly show you on the application table the product. You can see here this aluminium sandwich panel, and then you glue here the natural stone in a thin layer on it, or you can use wooden panels. So there are a lot of different possibilities for these lightweight constructions. What I have to mention, this product is a liquid product, so you can roll it, as you can see here on these pictures. You can apply it with a paintbrush, paint roller, or a very fine tooth spatula. And we have a long processing time of 45 minutes, because you can imagine usually for this application, you have big areas, big slabs, which you want to do, which want to bond together in a sandwich application, like 4 or 5 square meters ceramics, 6 millimeter ceramics, for example, or very thin natural stone plates, which you want to bond on big substructures. And here you need time to move, to adjust. And for that reason, we have done a 45 minutes application time. And this is an example of furniture, kitchen countertop, also living furniture, where you can do this ceramics on small under construction, like wooden carrier plates, where you can bond this very thin ceramics in a sandwich application, where it's important that you have a flexible, elastic, but still strong glue, because you can imagine aluminium, for example, and ceramic, they have quite different properties in expansion when there is some heat coming. And here you need some flexible material to cover this expansion. Yeah, I think enough talking. I will show you this product also on our application table again. So this is the unit. It's a 6 kg unit, so 6,000 gram, so a good big unit, because of course it's a sandwich adhesive. You need it for large areas, so it makes no sense to make it in small quantities. So this is a good unit. You can cover good areas, and then when you apply it, you can get this lightweight construction boards, for example. This is aluminium board. Here you have the glue. And this is a 6 millimeter ceramic, perfectly attached, very lightweight, but still strong. You can attach it to a wall, as a wall panel, as an elevator, for example, as a wall panel, but also for furniture, like here, this kefir Furnier, was heißt Furnier? Veneer, thank you, Otello. The Skiva veneer, which is very thin, only a few millimeters, which we applied here on this wooden MDF board. Otello, can you switch to the overhead camera so I can? Yes, exactly. You can see how thin it is. Yeah, it is only 1-2 millimeters natural stone veneer. Here, this is the color of the glue, so it's a quite light color. Yeah, light gray, nearly white color glue. You roll it, you apply it. With a roller or with some of these tooth spatulas. They have very fine tooth there, 1-2 millimeter. You can apply it, and then you have here a very nice lightweight construction. Or for example, this aluminium board. It's the same. When you watch here, you see this aluminium honeycomb. You see the glue, and you see the ceramic. So very thin, very lightweight panels. You can, generate there, create there. So you have unlimited amount of application fields here. If it is natural stone, if it is ceramics, if it is other materials, quartz composite, for example, which you want to glue on big areas on another substrate, yeah, like wood or aluminium or PVC or some other materials which have a different expansion properties than, for example, the ceramic. And this is Acupur 150 sandwich adhesive. So it's a quite interesting product for all the industry or interior builders where you want to do lightweight constructions, lightweight panels. So we have the right product for that. Good, enough talking from me. Otello, are there some questions?
Two questions. The first question is, does this product have other colors too?
No, this product comes in only one color, in this light gray, whitish color, because you will not see it anyway. It's between these two tiles. So there's only in one color it's available right now.
So in the second question, a viewer is asking, you are mentioning different substrates. Do I need primers for that?
Okay. It's a good question. In our technical data sheet, we mentioned some primers there, as actually one primer, AP30 is the name. This you need on special metals. There you can primer it. It's not always necessary. You can do some preliminary tests, but there are some primers available and recommended for some metal substrates. To primer them first, then apply the Acupur 150, and then put the substrate there or the ceramic there.
No more questions.
Okay, no more question. Then we move on to our next product. Good. So our next new product, it's not a new product, but it's actually an improvement of our actual current Acculux repair system. As you know, we have this Acculux repair system where you can fill small scratches, holes, cracks on corner and on edges of kitchen countertop, especially of polished natural stone quartz composite. Where you can really do some invisible repairs. We always demonstrate this set on our exhibitions, like in Verona or in the Stone Tech in Nuremberg. We always show this case, do some demonstrations in front of you guys. But as I mentioned, first let's do some examples so you get a better idea. So for example, some breakouts like this on the corner, you can repair very fast with this fillers, with this Acculux fillers. They are UV curing fillers. So yeah, there's a UV lamp included in the system. And there you can really invisible repair some breakouts, some scratches, some small holes on luxury objects like kitchen countertops, tables, bathrooms, etc., where it's not worth it to replace the object, but you have to repair it. And with this system, you can really repair it perfectly invisible. Also here, like a broken edge on a kitchen countertop, really can repair it perfectly in a few minutes with this Arkelux system. But as I mentioned earlier, the ceramic industry, the porcelain industry, these big slab ceramics, they are more and more moving also into kitchen countertops, also moving into the big bathrooms, vanity tops, et cetera. And when you here have some breakouts or some cracks or other damages, it was difficult, more difficult to repair them in a perfect way than, for example, a natural stone where it always looks the same. So as you know, a ceramic usually is formed from a layer, from a decor layer and a ground material. And usually their colors are not always the same. So you could have a very light, for example, white decor, but the ground material of the ceramic or porcelain has a totally different color, like brown or gray or something. And here it's difficult to do a proper repair. And for that reason, we have improved our Arkelux repair system with some different materials. So first of all, we added a transparent chill in a crystal version. So we had a crystal chill there, but this was a little bit cloudy and a little bit yellowish. But when it comes to the repair of the super white ceramics, porcelains, you need also a very crystal clear transparent filler. And this now we have with this transparent chill crystal. With that, you can mix now our colors, our white colors, and you can get still a perfect repair. A second new product is the Arkelux opaquing agent. And that's the reason what I just explained. A ceramic has usually a top color, yeah, a decor color, and the core has usually a different color. Some ceramics have quite similar. So you have, let's say, a white decor and a whitish core color, but some of them are also still like this one. You can see here the white decor, but the ground material is quite dark brown in this case. And here it's difficult to get a good filling and a good adaption of the color when you want to do a proper filling with our Arkelux fillers, because this Arkelux fillers, as I mentioned before, they get cured by this UV lamp. So what does it mean? That this Arkelux fillers, they are always a little bit translucent, so the light can shine through and cure them and harden them. And but when you have a dark substructure and you want to fill it and adapt it in a white color like the decor is here, it's quite difficult to get it really not shine through. So for this reason, we have this opaquing agent. This is a very white, dense color which you apply first on this area, then you cure it with the UV light, and then you can build up the repair with our Arkelux fillers, colors, and adapt it. A third new product is our Arkelux clear coat. This is for, let's say, glazed porcelain and ceramic, where you have this final glaze on the surface, because on natural stone, you can always do a polish in the end, yeah, and adapt the gloss of the repair a little bit. But when you have a ceramic, you cannot polish it, yeah, because you will destroy the surface then, or you even cannot polish it because it's so hard. But when you want to imitate a glazed surface, we have here this clear coat. This is a UV hardening clear coat. So you put this there as a last layer. You harden it also with this lamp, and then you get a perfect result, also a shiny result. The release agent, I will show you in a second what's about that product. I think I just show you the case. I will not do a repair because it's a very fast product, but it still needs some time to do a proper repair. So these are the new products. We have this crystal clear Arkelux filler. We have this opaquing agent. This is a very white. Let's do it on the overhead camera a little bit, maybe. Do we have a plate here? Yeah. This is a very white filler, which can be cured with the UV light, and this will cover, this will really cover the core of a ceramic perfectly. And then you have here this clear coat where you can do the final touch for the gloss of a glazed ceramic. And yeah, now we come to this, to the separating agent, to the release agent. This is when I explained we have a glazed ceramic, but we also have not honed ceramic, but ceramic with an antique finish, with not a polished finish, with a rough finish. Also, for example, this is not only an extra or a benefit for ceramic repair, but also for natural stone repair. For example, when you have flamed and brushed or antique finish natural stone, here was always the problem. The last touch of the Arkelux system, you need to put a foil, you harden it, and then you polish it and you get a gloss. But what if you don't want to have a gloss in your perfect repair? That's the reason when you have a structured material, you have to imitate the structure of the material. And for that reason, you need a release agent, because we have to make a copy of the substructure, of the surface of the ceramics or of the natural stone, to copy the structure and then to put it back on our repair work. And for that, we need the release agent. And how we do some of this copy, I will show you now in a short video and to make it more clear for you. Okay. Yes. So this is first, usually when we repair with our Arkelux system on polished materials, we placed this transparent foil on top of it. Then we cured it with our UV lamp and it was perfect. You just buffed it a little bit. You honed it a little bit with our polishing papers, and then you had a perfect repair. But now when it comes to a rough surface finish, you can adapt the color, but what you have also to adapt the structure. And this is quite difficult to do it manually, to adapt this structure. And for that reason, we make a surface imprint, like a copy, yeah, of the imprint of the surface. And this we will transfer then to the repair work. And how it's done, I will show you in this short video. First, we apply the release agent on an area where we want to copy the surface. So this is now a rough ceramic surface. You have to dry it. And now when it's dry, you can apply now the Arkelux filler. You can also apply different products like our platinum liquid, for example, or our Arkepox 5000 liquid. But of course, these products, they need time to cure. When you use the Arkelux, of course, it's in 1 minute, it's done with this UV lamp, you cure it, you get directly this imprint. I fast forward this video a little bit, so this was not a 1 minute curing. And now you can see, thanks to this release agent, you can remove this imprint very easily. And now the structure of the ceramic surface is now copied in this imprint, in this piece of cured glue. And this I will use now as a final step when I do my repair work, for example. So I have here a broken edge. I work like I used to work. I apply a primer, our primer. I mix my Arkelux colors to match the material here, the color of the ceramic or natural stone. So I mix them, I fill it, I adapt these colors. In this case, it's a Carrara copy. And now I apply my imprint. And now I cure, not through this plastic foil, but through this imprint. I cure with the UV lamp my bonding. And now, thanks to this release agent, which I have put also on my imprint, I can easily remove it. I just grind a little bit the excess, and now I have a perfect result, a perfect repair of the ceramic, and I have copied this structure here is also here. So with this technique, you can really repair also ceramics in a perfect way, which was not possible before in a good way, let's say. So, and not only ceramics, but also now natural stone, when you have a flamed and polished or antique finished surface, you can perfectly copy this surface and do a repair work there, and it will be more or less invisible. So are there any questions to the Arkelux?
Yes, there's one interesting question of a viewer. He's asking, why do you need the opaquing agent? Can't they just simply take the colored filler?
Yes, I explained earlier already that the Arkelux colors, they has to be, as you saw just in the video, you have to mix them always with a little bit transparent Arkelux filler. So they are a little bit translucent. And when you have a dark core, and you have a white decor, and you just put the Arkelux fillers there, for example, a white Arkelux filler, you will see this dark core, this dark ground material can shine through. And that's the reason we have this opaquing agent, which will block out the color of the submaterial, and you can then build up your repair on top of it. When the color of the core and the decor is the same, you don't need this opaquing agent. It's only when there is a big difference between decor color and sub color or ground color.
Another question, Johannes. Mm-hmm. Can I use Arkelux repair system also outdoors?
Yes, of course. Also a good question. Arkelux system is for store stable and UV stable. So it's all often used in the tombstone industry when they replace, for example, the lettering, the names on a tombstone, for example, or they add some. So they have to change the letters a little bit. So they have these drill holes and they want to make them invisible. And for that application, the Arkelux system is also perfect to use to fill these small holes, to make them invisible in a very fast, efficient way without demounting the whole tombstone, bring it in the factory or in the workshop and do the work there.
No more questions.
Okay, good. Then we come to our next topic, goodbye stain. So this is a special cleaner for organic discolorations. So especially in the kitchen or in the living room, in the dining room, we have a lot of organic stainings there, like fruit stains, coffee stains, the tea stains, but also from fruits, as I said, just here some cranberries or other colored strawberries, wine, all this kind of organic stainings, especially on light material, but on all natural stone, but also on quartz composite, for example, engineered stone, they can leave some discolorations there. And these discolorations can be easily removed with this goodbye stain. This is a slightly alkaline product, so you can use it also on all marble and limestone, also on polished surfaces is not an issue. You can use it on all of those materials. And as I said, quartz, usually the manufacturers say quartz, so engineered stone, quartz composite, they're quite strong against stainings, but also these materials, when you have light colored quartzites, like white ones, for example, they can take this color of a coffee, for example, when you leave a coffee there too long. And then it's sometimes very difficult to take it out. And in this case, the goodbye stain is a perfect product for that. Example is here. This is some hair dye. So this is the perfect example of organic coloring or discoloration. So this is the most discoloration you can get organically, I believe. So this was left there on this window seal. I think here it was the case that it was also forgotten that they spoiled it, or they did not see that they spoiled it there. So it was left there for many, many days. And then they needed to remove it. And here the goodbye stain is a perfect product for that. You apply it, you remove it. But I think enough talking. I will show you this product in an application, in a practical demonstration now. Yeah, we have here our white, nice tassos, and we have some fruit stain here from some strawberries, but also, as I said, coffee stains, tea bags or tea stains, when you just have some liquid tea bags, you drop it there, you forgot it, goes into the material, chews, stains, all this material can stain our natural stone and can leave some, ugly discolorations, which are hard to remove. So let's move to the overhead camera. Yes, I think I move here. So you see now this two stains of the strawberries. And now this is the goodbye stain. Yes, you can apply it in a different way. You can put it directly on the stain, or you can take it on a wooden cotton pad, or you apply it like here. I want to do it more locally with this pivot. So I apply it here a little bit. And now I just let it react for a few minutes. And you can see already it starts to take the color out, the discoloration out. Usually we say when you have stubborn stains and stains which are there for many, many days, for example, you can leave it also there 10, 20, 30 minutes on the stone. Just make sure that it does not dry. Yeah. So the product has to stay liquid. And then you can leave it there for 10, 20, 30 minutes until the stain is gone. Then you wipe the stain or the liquid off. You clean it with a little bit water, which I also do now. And then you have a nice surface again. I think that's so far from our goodbye stain. I think it looks already good. It's only there, how much, Otello? Maybe 2 minutes?
Two minutes, yes.
2 minutes, yes. So, okay, let's move back. I will remove it now. Yeah, you can see, or better, you see nothing. Here was the stain. Now it's removed. I take the liquid. And now I just wash it with a little bit. It's just some Akemi water. Very exclusive Akemi water. So I wash it here. And you can see the stain is completely gone. I think it is a good example here. Here used to be this big red stain from the strawberry, and now it's completely gone. So I think this is a perfect example for organic stain removal with this goodbye stain. Yeah, so far from this cleaning, special cleaner, are there any questions, Otello?
Yes, two questions. One question, can I use the stain remover on sandstone?
Yes, of course. You can use it on all natural stone. Yeah, marble, granite, sandstone, limestone, quartzite, etc. It will not harm any stone, and it will remove all this type of organic stainings.
Another question is, can we remove wood stains with this?
Yes, also possible. Yes. If you have, for example, when you left some wooden piece or some was heißt Untersetzer? Sometimes where you put, I don't know the English word for it, where you put your glass on it, on the table, you have sometimes there, you have left them, you have some wooden piece there where you place it there, and when it becomes wet, maybe it can some discoloration there. Of course, wood stains can be removed also. It's organic staining, and you can remove it also with this goodbye stain. Any more questions?
There's one question. What is the difference between anti-green power, or I guess algae moss remover power, and goodbye stain?
This is a good question because they work similar. They have a similar application field, but not quite similar. The organics, the goodbye stain remover is more for organic discolorations, more in the living area, like food stainings, tea stainings, coffee stainings, and that type of stuff. Of organic stainings. The algae moss remover power or long life, this is our outdoor range. This is more for let's say like algae lichen, like this organic growth, yeah, like this living organic organisms on the stone surface. So they are formulated more in this way, and this is more formulated for this organic staining coming like a stain builder on top of a stone and not like a green algae or lichen which grows on outside the stone on the top of the stone. So this is a little bit of difference. The formulations are a little bit different, but yes, the application field is similar. Both are organic stains and discolorations. One are living organic stains like algae and lichen. Here you need the algae moss remover power, and this is stainings which comes from fruits and teas and coffee on top of it.
Another interesting question: can I remove oil stains with it?
No, oil stains, of course, food oil is also organic, but this is a little bit different case. For really oil stains, we have our oil increase remover paste, because really stubborn oil stains, when they are deep inside the stone, you need some solvent cleaners for that. Yeah. Thank you, Otello, for the oil increase remover paste, by the way.
You're welcome.
So for oil stains, you need our oil increase remover paste, because this is a solvent-based product which goes deep inside the stone, dissolves the oil, and brings it back on the surface. Here, this is about discoloration, organic discoloration.
No more questions.
No more questions. Okay, thank you. So we move on to our last new product. Took me a little bit longer to come to my place now. So now we come to our last new product, a lettering primer spray. So basically, this is a primer for our lettering colors and lettering color sprays. This is all for our tombstone masons, for the tombstone industry, where we do the lettering inside the tombstones. And this is special to seal the open port surfaces. For example, when you have the sandblasted lettering color, the letterings, when you open them with a sandblasting machine or you mill them out, for example, the surface sometimes is quite rough. And especially when you have dark stones and you apply then a white lettering color, sometimes the stone still shines a little bit through, and you have applied a lettering color maybe two times to get a good result. And for that, the primer spray is perfect. It has also some other advantages. Of course, it improves also the adhesion of our lettering colors. So the lifetime of our lettering colors is increased when you use before the primer spray. Also, it has the filling power. So as I said, when you mill it out, some letterings, when you mill them out, and they're quite rough, and with the primer spray you smoothen it, so when you apply later the color, the lettering color, it gets a better appearance. And of course, and this is one of the main topics, you intensify the color and the covering of our lettering colors. So when you maybe in on some materials you used maybe two coats of our lettering color, now you need only one. So the color gets more intense, and the covering with the colors, with all colors from white to dark to black to golden, gets increased. But I think I showed that to you also in a practical way. Of course, I will not apply the lettering spray here in this our video room, because then we will have problems breathing. No, this is a lettering spray. You shake it, you spray it crosswise. I will show you now in a video how you apply it. And then the result is that you can see here, we have done this. Yeah, I think you can see it in this way. On the top side, on the top half, we have put our primer spray underneath, and then we have done one coat with our lettering colors, and you can see the difference. I think on the over, yes, on this camera it's better. Yeah, here it comes. You can see here the top side. We have used the primer before, and on the bottom side not. And then we applied one coat of our lettering colors, and you can see all colors get improved. If it is a very bright white one, if it is a golden color or a very strong red, all of those colors get improved quite strong with the primer. The color comes out very good. The covering effect is very good. So this is the advantage of a primer spray. And of course, the lifetime will be increased also when you use the primer before. So when you apply it 15 minutes, 20 minutes after you apply it, when it's dry, you can start using the lettering color directly or the lettering color spray. So you have also no delay there. You can, it's a fast working product. In some cases, when it's surface tech free, let's say, you can start applying your color. Sometimes it's the case when we did our tests, also after 5 to 10 minutes, already you are tech free, you can start putting your lettering color on top of it. Are there any questions to that, or we just do the video before and then answering the questions? So tell us.
One question that was also in the German webinar, the quick question, are there other colors of the lettering primer?
Ah, no, the lettering primer comes only in one color. It's you will see it now in the video. It's a light, very light gray, nearly whitish color. But if this is the case, if you're wondering when you apply now a black lettering color, this is not a problem. Also, we tested it on black colors. Even the black color gets more intense when you first put the lettering primer spray there underneath. Okay, Otello, let's move to my desk, and I will show you the application video. Yeah, of course, first the picture of my stone, which I just showed you. You can see here again, the top side was used the primer before, on the bottom not. And I think you can see the difference of the intensity of the colors and the covering properties of the colors quite increased. Yeah, so you can see here perfect filling there with the primer. Yeah, this is now a lettering color a sandblast foil, where we first, of course, sandblast our lettering. So we roughen the stone surface, then we apply our lettering primer spray. Of course, shake it well before you use it. And you can see here the color, it's quite light. And yeah, we say here after 15 to 20 minutes, you can use our lettering colors. In this case, it's a red, it's a nice Akemi red. Here we apply it with a brush, with a paintbrush. But also when you want to apply our lettering color sprays, you can apply them perfectly on this primer. Here we use a white color, and you can see here the result. When we remove the sandblast foil, you can get this nice perfect result. High coverage, nice colors, rich color, and a very long lifetime of our lettering colors. Good. That was all. This is our new products, which we wanted to show you now on an exhibition in Nuremberg. But yeah, because of the COVID-19, we cannot do this exhibition in person. So we have to do it in this webinar-based version. Just one information, all products which I have demonstrated here, you can order them right away. They are on stock. Talk with your distributors, talk with us. So these products are available, are all on stock. If there are not more questions, I will just do some organizatoric.
No more questions.
Okay, thank you, Otello. Topics and for our upcoming webinars. So we will do a short summer break in June and July. So no webinars in the summer. We will proceed in August, end of August, with our webinar Outdoor Bonding, where we talk, definitely we will talk again about our Everclear 300, which I showed you in the beginning of the webinar. But also, we will talk with you about other outdoor adhesive, which we can do maybe also on the underwater or other outdoor applications where there's a lot of humidity, where there's a lot of stress, different materials to bond together, and for store stable bonding. So there we will talk about these topics. Yeah. If you say, okay, this is too long for me, yeah, till August, I cannot wait to get new information from Akemi. always please write us at our webinar at akemi.de or info@akemi.de. We can always organize some trainings, some webinar trainings for you for some a few topics. When you say, I have 1, 2, 3 problems I want to talk about, we can do it in a webinar way. That's always possible. If I don't believe that traveling will be this year quite possible, so we have to use this webinar to work together to train you. So please, if you have some requests, write us, call us, and we can find a way to train you, to show you some products, show you some applications. And hopefully maybe in September the Verona exhibition will take place. Until now it takes place. We'll see in how what a format and how big the exhibition will be. But we are positive that we will be there. And yeah, let's see. Hopefully we can sit together soon and drink a beer, drink a wine, have a chat, and talk about new products in person and not in this virtual way. If there are not more questions, Otello?
No more questions.
No more questions. Okay. So yeah, still, if you have questions later on, write us, or if you missed a webinar before or you want to watch this webinar again, write us. We can send you a link where you can watch the webinar again. Okay. So far, thank you for joining us, for watching, and I hope to see you in August again to our webinar, Outdoor Bonding. Thank you very much.